Good morning everybody. So we are in chapter 4, structure of the atom. So as we have discussed in our previous video presentations, the discovery of electrons by Sir J.J. Thomson, discovery of proton by Goldstein, and structure of the atom, Bohr's model, discovery of neutron. And today in this video presentation, I would like to discuss the atomic number, mass number, valences and electronic configurations, and even we will discuss about the isotopes and isobars. So first of all, I would like to start for the valency. So in our NCERT textbook, the valency, so valency we are aware about, and we have learned how the electrons in an atom arrange in the different cells and orbit. So here valence electrons can be defined. The electrons present in the outermost cell of an atom are known as the valence electrons. So in exam it can be asked, define valency and valence electrons. So valency is a combining property of electrons in its outermost cell, that is a valency. And valence electrons, the electrons present in the outermost cell of an atom are known as the valence electrons. In our previous class, from the Bohr and Bohri scheme, we got to know that the outermost cell of an each and every 1 to 20 elements, that valency, that electron configuration, like hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, up to calcium, 1 to 20 elements, and there how to fill up the electrons in its outermost cell. So when electron is filled up in the first cell and then it transfer to the next cell, suppose lithium we can take, so valency of lithium is 1, so valence electron it has 1. So here you can see the lithium it has atomic number 3. So here 2 electrons in first orbit and 1 electron in a second orbit. So that 1 electron we consider as a valence electron, because 2 electrons are filled up in the first orbit and then 1 is left. So it comes into the accommodate into the next cell. So that is 1 valency. Then beryllium here 2 valency, then boron 3 valency. You can understand, because outermost cell how many electrons are accommodated, that shows the valency, that shows the valence electrons. So everywhere 1 to 20 elements and their valence electrons, by the same method we can find it out. So all my dear students, in the composition of atoms of the first 18 elements with electron distribution in various cells is given here. So here start from hydrogen, so symbol is H, atomic number is 1, number of protons 1, number of neutrons, that we will discuss what is the atomic number, what is the atomic mass, the mass number, that after this we will discuss. So number of neutrons, number of electrons, number of protons, how many are there, so that all things we will discuss. And distribution of electrons in K, L, M, N cell, and what is the valency of the particular element. So hydrogen valency is 1, because the atomic number is 1 and number of protons are 1. Then helium, second number is helium, He, atomic number is 2. So now here you can understand, in K cell 2 electrons are accommodated, so maximum 2 electrons means valency is 0. Okay, now lithium, as we have discussed, 3 atomic number is 3, so 1 is left in the next cell, so valency is 1. Beryllium valency is 2. Boron valency is 3. Carbon valency is 4, tetravalency. Then nitrogen valency 3, oxygen valency 2, fluorine valency 1. Then again the neon come 2, 8, so that is valency 0. So like that we are able to find it out all the 1 to 18 elements and their valencies. In phosphorus, here one optional there, in that two type of valencies are there. You can see here phosphorus P 15 number, so in that 2, 8, 5. So sometimes the valency is 3 also and sometimes valency 5 also. Then argon 18, then after 19 potassium will come and 20 calcium will come. So here we can easily understand the electrons which are in the its outermost shell, and all other elements have atoms with the 8 electrons in the outermost shell, so that is fixed shell, so that is we consider as inert elements. The combining capacity of the atoms of other elements, that is their tendency to react and to form molecules with atoms of the same or different elements, was thus explained as an atom to attain a fully filled outermost cell. So as we know that once the first cell is filled up, it transfer to the next cell, then two first cell, second is 8, then vice versa it will go. An outermost cell which had 8 electrons was said to be possessed an octet. So octet means that cell is filled up. Octet means 8 electrons. So atoms would thus react so as to achieve an octet in the outermost cell. This was done by the sharing, gaining and losing electrons. The number of electrons gained, lost or shared so as to make the octet of electrons in the outermost cell gives us directly the combining capacity of elements, that is the valency what we have discussed. So for example, hydrogen, lithium, sodium atom contains one electron each in their outermost cell. Hydrogen 1, lithium you can see here, once again if you see lithium it is a 3, then sodium 11, so everywhere the valency is 1. So therefore each one of them can lose one electrons, so they are said to be have valency of 1. Now we can understand that what is the valency of magnesium and aluminium. By looking at this aluminium, it is 13 number, and here it is given aluminium. So aluminium is 13 and magnesium is 12. So directly we can find it out the valency by using the electron configuration 282 and 283. So magnesium the valency is 2, as you can see here, and aluminium valency is 3. So generally it can be happened by the magnesium has 2 electrons in the outermost cell and aluminium has 3 electrons in the outermost cell. So directly we can consider the valency of magnesium is 2 and aluminium is 3. So Mg plus 2 and Al plus 3. If the number of electrons in the outermost cell of an atom is close to its fully capacity, this valency is determined in a different way. For example, the fluorine atom has 7 electrons in the outermost cell because the atomic number is 9. So outermost cell 7 electrons are there and its valency could be 7, but it is not like that because it can gain one electron from the other element, so that is one valency. So but it is easy to understand. For the fluorine to again one electron instead of losing 7 electrons, because it need only one electron to complete one octet. It is better to get one electron from other element instead of losing 7 electrons. So hence the valency is determined by subtracting 7 electrons from the octet, and this gives a valency of 1 for fluorine. So valency can be calculated in a similar manner for the oxygen also, as the oxygen atomic number is 8, so 2 8. So like that also we can easily understand 2 2 6 for the oxygen. So oxygen need 2 electrons to complete its octet. So that is why we can easily say that oxygen, the valency is 2. Therefore, any atom of each element has a definite combining capacity that consider as a valency. So atom of each element has a definite combining capacity, it defined as valency. So that in table we have seen 1 to 18 in your chemistry today, 1 to 20 elements and their electron configuration, even the valencies are given, that also you can refer. Now important topic that we are going to study, that is atomic number and mass number. So here when we study the atomic number, as we have discussed in our previous chapter, Mendeleev's periodic table, in that chapter will come in your syllabus also, the atomic, that is a Mendeleev's periodic table, in 10th standard it will come. So in that we will study the Mendeleev's periodic table, in that, and a modern periodic table and Mendeleev's periodic table, that all things we will study. But before that we should know atomic number and atomic mass. So we know that the protons are present in the nucleus of an atom. It is the number of proton of an atom. So remember that atomic number, which is given on the base of the number of protons of an atom, we determines its atomic number. It denoted by Z. So atomic number can be denoted by Z. So here we can say that all atoms of an element have the same atomic number, Z. In fact, elements are defined by the number of protons they possess. For example, hydrogen, Z is 1, means atomic number is 1. Because in hydrogen atom, only one proton is present in the nucleus. In hydrogen, neutrons are absent. Similarly, for carbon, Z is 6. Z is 6. So atomic number of carbon is 6. Therefore, the atomic number is defined as the total number of protons present in the nucleus of an atom. So remember that this is a definition. The atomic number is defined as the total number of protons present in the nucleus of an atom. Now next, which is very much important, that is mass number. After studying the properties of subatomic particles of an atom, we can conclude that the mass of an atom is practically due to protons and neutrons alone. So that is, find it out, that can be measure the weight, generally mass of protons and neutrons in a nucleus. These are present in the nucleus of an atom. Hence, the protons and neutrons are called nucleons. So, in exam, it can be asked, in MCQ, protons and neutrons are also called blank. They are called as nucleons. Therefore, the mass of an atom resides in its nucleus. For example, we can take one example, carbon is 12 unit because of it has 6 protons and 6 neutrons. So that is why, and as we know that the mass number can be denoted as A. So here 6U plus 6U means 6 protons and 6 neutrons, it make 12 unit. So mass number is 12. Similarly, the mass of aluminium is 27. So 13 protons and 14 neutrons. The mass number is defined as the sum of total number of protons and neutrons present in the nucleus of an atom. The mass number is defined the sum of the total number of protons and neutrons present in the nucleus of an atom, where atomic number is defined on behalf of its number of protons in the nucleus. But mass number is defined the sum of the protons and neutrons present in the nucleus of an atom. In the notation for an atom, the atomic number, mass number and symbol of the element are to be written as, suppose symbol of element hydrogen we can take or oxygen we can take. So mass number always at the top, mass number A, and atomic number, that is J. So A to J, remember that mass number is A, atomic number is J. So symbol which we can use any. Suppose I can take hydrogen, you can take here carbon itself directly. So carbon, symbol of carbon C, atomic number is 6, mass number is 12. Okay, so like that we can easily find it out. Even we can take example of nitrogen also, N7, 7 is atomic number, 14 is mass number. So A to Z, A at the top, B, Z at the bottom. So mass number, that is for the A, atomic number, that is for the J. Now next topic we will discuss, that is very crucial, very much important, isotopes and isobars. So my dear students, in nature the number of atoms of some elements have been identified. Total 119 elements are there in our periodic table that you will study in 10th standard, which have the same atomic number but different mass numbers. For example, take the case of hydrogen atom. It has 3 atomic species. Remember, hydrogen I am talking about. It has 3 atomic species, namely protium, deuterium and tritium. Protium H11, deuterium H21 and tritium H31. Or you can speak protium H11, deuterium 12 and tritium 13. The atomic number of each is 1 and the mass number is 1, 2 and 3. So these are considered to be an isotopes. For example, carbon also same thing. Carbon C6 12, C6 14, and chlorine also, chlorine 1735 and chlorine 1737. You can take 3 examples for the isotopes. First you can take hydrogen in that 3 atomic species, protium, deuterium and tritium. In carbon, carbon 12, carbon 14. In chlorine, chlorine 35, 37. On the basis of these examples, isotopes are defined as the atoms of the same element having the same atomic number. Isotopes can be defined having the same atomic number but different atomic mass. Okay, remember once again, the isotopes can be defined the elements having the same atomic number and different atomic mass. Therefore we can say that there are 3 isotopes of hydrogen atoms, namely protium, deuterium and tritium. So this is about the isotopes, and isobars are totally opposite to the isotopes. So here many elements consist of mixture of isotopes. Each isotopes of an element is a pure substance. The element properties of isotopes are similar, but their physical properties are different. So here the chemical properties and the physical properties, when we talk about the chemical properties of isotopes, are similar because their atomic numbers are same, and their physical properties are different because their atomic mass is different. Now chlorine occurs in the nature in two isotopic forms with masses 35U and 37U in the ratio of 3:1. Obviously the question arises in our mind, why it should be? Because we can easily understand chlorine, if an element has no isotopes, then the mass of its atom would be the same as the sum of the protons and neutrons in it. But if an element occur in isotopic forms, then we have to know the percentage of each isotopic form, and then average mass is calculated. So here we can easily calculate the average atomic mass of chlorine atom on the basis of the above data. So here 35, that is 75 upon 100, 37, that is 25 upon 100. So here when you do calculation, we will easily get the average atomic mass of chlorine is 35.5 unit. So because it's 35 plus 37 almost it is 72. So when it divide, so we'll get the half of it, that is 35.5 unit. So this does not mean that any one atom of chlorine has a fractional mass of 35.5 unit. It means that if you take a certain amount of chlorine, it will contain both isotopes of chlorine and the average mass is 35.5 unit. So my dear students, you have to understand two things. Two type of isotopes of chlorine are there. One is 35 unit and 37 unit. But when we take the average of that, it will be 35.5 unit. So that only you have to understand. Now last and final topic, we will discuss. Before that, we have to discuss the applications of isotopes. That is always crucial for your exam. So applications of isotopes. Since the chemical properties of all the isotopes of an element are the same, normally we are not concerned about the taking a mixture. So here it's explanation part, but some atoms have special properties which find them useful in various fields. An isotope of uranium is used as a fuel in nuclear reactions. Even this type of uranium can be used for the nuclear power also. Nuclear power station, nuclear reactors, that also you know. And an isotope of cobalt is used in the treatment of cancer. And isotope of iodine is used in the treatment of goiter. So uranium, it is also isotope. Cobalt also isotope. Iodine also isotope. So uranium can be used in nuclear reactions, cobalt can be used in cancer, and iodine can be used in goiter. So last topic for this chapter, that is isobars. Here two elements, that is calcium, atomic number is 20, and argon, atomic number is 18. Okay, the number of electrons in this atom is different, but the mass number of both this element is 40. So here it is a totally opposite to the isotopes. In isotopes, what is there? Atomic numbers are same and atomic masses are different. In isobar, opposite is that atomic number is different, atomic mass is same. So calcium and argon, the atomic number is 20 and 18. But atomic mass is 40. So that the total number of nucleon is the same in the atoms of this pair of element. Atom of the different element with the different atomic numbers which have the same mass number are known as isobars. So isobar can be defined atoms of the different element with the different atomic numbers but having the same atomic mass or mass number, that is considered to be a isobars. So in exam it can be asked, distinguish between isotopes and isobars, distinguish between atomic number and mass number. So this type of questions are always be crucial for your exam. So remaining, if any topic will be left, that we will discuss in our next video presentation. So up to here you will find out some videos from YouTube related. You just search on atomic mass number, isobars, and you will get the particular video, and that also make you to understand in that video. So thank you and have a nice day.